Hello student, welcome to this class. So in this class we are going to design for the piston. Okay, so where piston we call as a, it is an heart of the IC engine that reciprocate in the cylinder. So what are the important parts of the piston? First we will come to the top of the piston, we call as a thickness of the piston head, and below the thickness of the piston head you will have the ring section, and below the ring section you will have the skirt section up to this point. Okay, now at this point, at the middle of the piston, that will be called as a piston pin, where the in the piston pin where the connecting rod will be connected to the piston pin. So these are the important parts of an piston. Now when considering the design of piston, it's based on the two factors we are going to be designed. One, we have to consider the material property, another by considering the heat produced in the piston. Okay, now based on the strength, according to the Grassof formula, where thickness of the head, that is TH, is equal to D under root of 3 by 16 into P max divided by sigma B. Okay, so using this equation we can calculate the thickness of the head, where sigma B, that is nothing but it is an allowable bending stress. For the different material we have to consider the different their values, like 35 to 40 megapascal for cast iron you have to consider, and for 50 to 90 megapascal for aluminium alloy. And if you are having the ultimate tensile stress, so there you need to consider a factor of safety as 4 to 5. So this is about the based on the strength. If you want to calculate the based on the strength, that is the equation. Now by considering the heat, dissipation, where thickness of the head is equal to H into 10 power of 3 divided by 12.56 K into Tc minus T, where H we called as a heat flow through the piston head, that will be the in the unit of kilojoules per second or watts. So that is equal to C into HCV into M into BP into 10 power of 3. Now we will come to know what is C, where C, it indicates an constant representing the temperature in the engine, piston engine. So generally the C value, it will be taken as 0.05. Now HCV, that is high calorific value, where high calorific value, that is taken as 45 into 10 power of 3 kilojoules. So here it is given 45 into 10 power of 3 kilojoules per kg for diesel engine, and if it is an petrol engine, 48 into 10 power of 3 kilojoules per kg for petrol engine. That is the high calorific value of the fuel in kilojoules per kg. Now where M indicates, that is the mass of the fuel used in kg per brake power second. Okay, the mass of the fuel will be M. Now BP, that is the brake power of the engine per cylinder. Okay, so after that, once we calculated the thickness of the head, you need to calculate the another parameters by taking the by referring the thickness of the head, where we can calculate the H1 value. So H1 will be the, so this is the outer outer thickness of, we have taken as H1. So H1 is equal to, in this range it should be have in this range, so TH to 1.2 TH. So TH, again it is the thickness of the head. Now H2, it will be the thickness of the ring section. Okay, from here to here, the total distance you can take in the range from 0.75 to 1.0 H. Okay, the total distance. Sometimes in the piston we use two to five rings, it will be used based on the application of the piston. Now T1, so T1, that indicates it is the thickness of the skirt, or thickness of the barrel it will be called. Okay, so that is T1 is equal to 0.03 D plus B plus 4.9 millimeter. So it is an cylindrical portion of the piston. So the maximum value we can take as this one. Okay, so we called as it is a piston barrel thickness. Okay, now T2. So where T2 will be the below portion. So that is written as 0.25 plus 0.25 to 0.35 T1. Okay, so in this empirical relation we can get the T2 value. Okay, now coming to the so length of the piston. So this is an total length of the skirt from here. LS is the length of the skirt below the ring section to the end of the piston. That will be the total length of the skirt. So that we can obtain using this relation mu into pi by 4 into d into p max divided by pbs. Okay, where pbs that range from 0.25 to 0.5 megapascal, and mu is the Poisson's ratio that will be considered 0.1 to be taken. Now again the total length, L is the total length of the piston, that is H1 plus LS plus length of the ring section. It means H1 will be this distance, okay, where we'll have the thickness of the head, again ring section, length of the ring section, and also the length of the skirt, that is LS. This will be the total length of the piston. So it includes all the total distance. Okay, now again when it comes to the maximum pressure, where P is equal to pi by 4 d square into P max, using this relation you will get the P. Okay, now where B it is called as so now here where B is equal to D under root 3PW divided by sigma T. So this equation it is used for to calculate the parameter for the piston ring. Okay, so first we will draw the parameter for the piston ring. So suppose a ring, it will be a cylindrical portion. So here at the ends it will be open. Okay, now here we will call the top section, which will be thickness of the piston ring, and this will be the width of the piston ring. Okay, so width of the piston ring, that is taken as B is the width, and thickness it will be H. Okay, so H will be the thickness of the piston ring and B will be the width. Okay, so here to calculate the B is nothing but the width of the piston ring. So this will be the width of the piston ring. For that you will have this equation, where PW that range from 0.025 to 0.042 megapascal, and tensile stress in the piston material it should be taken as 85 to 110 megapascal for cast iron. Okay, and again H it will be the thickness of the piston. So that is range from 0.7 to 1B. So 0.7 to B we can take to calculate the H. So this is about the piston parameter. And next you need to calculate the G. So G is the, that as we said, there is an opening at the piston ring. For that distance, that will be taken as G. So that range from 3.5 to 4B. Okay, so after that this is the thickness of the piston pin. Okay, so width of the piston pin TR is equal to TH by 3 to TH by 2. So in that range we have to consider the piston pin. okay. So for number of ribs and 4 to 6 ribs if it is, okay. Now again based on the bearing consideration, so here it will be a piston pin, it will it acts at the center, there will be rod where the connecting rod is connected, so that DP we can calculate is equal to pi by 4 into D square by LP into P max divided by PBP. Okay, so PBP that is equal to 25 megapascal, DI is equal to 0.6 DP, so DB is equal to 1.4 DP for cast iron, 1.5 DP for aluminium alloy. Okay, now by considering the bending consideration, sigma B is equal to 4 by pi PD into DP power of 4 minus DI power of 4 into DP. So maximum bending stress that is 84 megapascal for carbon steel and 140 megapascal for alloy steel. So now the piston clearance that should be 0.0375 to 0.1875 m. Okay. So these are the major parts which are going to be designed in the piston. So you have to consider all these factors to calculate the parameters. Okay. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe the channel for more videos. In the next video, we are going to cover design of this spur gear and design of the connecting rod and also the design of the helical gears. Okay. So so in this way we are going to solve the design of the different parts of IC engines. So thank you for watching.